Tribe, it's been a while. I'm Rav, and I'm here to tell you guys how to play Rex. We're going to start off by telling you about the Zugzug King himself. Tyrannosaurus Rex is a large apex carnivore that is the embodiment of I bite, I tank, I win. Being the king of the bruiser class by far and having the highest damage in the game, many will be very wary of you, and if you play your cards right, you can face tank most of the playables that throw themselves your way. Rex, unlike other creatures, only has one attack, and that's its bite, which does the highest base damage in the game at 425. The bite, when used with right click, turns into a down bite, making killing ankle biters and smaller creatures slightly easier, but if I'm going to be truthful, this is less useful than I would like to admit for reasons I'll explain later. Rex only has one ability called Devastating Ambush, which is basically a big speed boost at the cost of turning. Honestly, as a Rex player, this ability is pretty meh compared to the other abilities in the game, and you'll most likely only use it to catch up to unsuspecting paras or revenators, and maybe if you have enough time to get away from certain creatures if you have prepped the 10 second wait time, though due to your low stamina, this really won't make much of a difference. Now that you know a bit about Rex, let's talk about how this bad boy plays. Rex is the face tank king, and because of this, it can bully pretty much every creature in the game, off of objectives and other stuff. Feel free to go into large groups of unsuspecting paras and not get punished at all, or go for more dangerous prey and fight a Psy or a Poto and test your skills there. You have the health and definitely the damage to take whatever you want and kill whoever you want, and just the name Tyrannosaurus Rex alone will make people think twice about trying you. At higher skill levels of play, Rex is also quite dangerous, as good Rex players can make a lot of their unfavorable matchups work out for them by scaling pretty hard into the late game just naturally. Now that you kind of understand how it plays, let's go over some matchups for Rex. First creature we're going to go up against is Para. Para is a fairly easy matchup if you can actually catch one. To be totally honest, they are pretty similar to you in terms of playstyle, but in exchange for raw stats, like damage and tank stats, they instead have a lot more stamina and overall a more balanced playstyle in terms of QOL. Once they start running, the chances of catching them are pretty slim, so try and get a lot of injury stacked on them or have stamina bite. You should also be pretty mindful of the stomps, as Para stomps quite quickly and does a lot of damage, and can actually out DPS you if they purely use stomp and don't headbutt you. This being said, most Para players are more than likely run away from you, even if you're right in their face, which may give you a few easy hits on their tail anyways. Wehevenator and Megaraptor. Wehevenator and Megaraptor can be quite a hassle for Rex, as they can turn and run much quicker than Rex and can also ride Rex fairly easily. That being said, you pretty much kill them in one bite, so one good brake check or tail nip pretty much makes them a goner. Megaraptor is the more frustrating one of the two because it has a literal get out of jail free card, or can use it to get directly behind you and more than likely kill you due to Rex's very poor turn. Wehevenators will probably be more cautious towards you, but they can also literally see every stat if they have the talent maxed, so if you're low HP, you should be prepared to get dived. The new and improved coffee table, aka Psychania. Psy can be a very hard fight if you're new to fighting them, and can be very punishing to fight, as injury does not actually affect them, but it will affect you. The reflect ability that they have is a direct counter to you, and they can also build stamina bite to pretty much instantly cripple you, as you have the smallest stamina pool in the game. I recommend getting strong bones and unbreakable to mitigate the effect of injury, and try and bait out reflex by fake biting, but if I'm going to be completely honest, these guys don't give much in the way of food, even with the new update increasing their weight, despite how much of a fight they can put up. So you need to weigh in the cost versus reward. Apatosaurus Rex. This is, in my opinion, Rex's second hardest matchup, tied with Psychania at the moment, and the reason is because unlike Rex's counterpart Acro, Rex doesn't really have actually a good way to fight Appa, unless they have nobody or nothing by them, or don't actually know how to fight. Fighting Apato all in all is very dangerous, as you can get stunlocked and also have a chance to do zero damage, as the Tailwind Whipping doesn't really let you bite it, so I would recommend staying away from Apatos unless you're extremely confident. Not to mention that Apato also gets the hurt with Para, and I already went over how Para went over earlier in this video. Most Apatos will try and run through you once, so getting strong bones and stamina bite will massively help you, as when they can't run, they're at a massive disadvantage. Try and have a buddy to fight at least a solo Apato at the minimum, and be careful of Paras, as they make this matchup extremely hard, even if there's only one Apato. Kohelaceratops. Koa is a pretty hard fight for Rex if you don't have a build against it, as it counters Rex's face tank strategy. You pretty much have to build Standbite and Stoic in order to stop it from stomping completely, and even then, if it's in a cave or against the wall, it's an almost impossible fight. If you do not have any of the talents I mentioned earlier, I would strongly recommend not fighting Koa, but if you do for some reason, try and get behind Koa as fast as possible without getting stomped, then you might have a chance. Once you're behind Koa on any build, to be honest, you will more than likely win, but for the best possible chance, I'd recommend a Speed Rex build with Stamina Bite or a Comet's Arrival build with strong bones and HP for these guys, as that's what I have found to be the best at killing them. They also take 40% less exhausting bite damage, but versus Rex, that is still pretty much a game changer to the amount it takes anyways, even with the reduction. Acro. Acro is not super hard for Rex in most situations, especially when they don't have high intimidation RAR and less numbers or even numbers, but the biggest problem is actually catching them. Acro has a lot more stamina than Rex, and one bite from an Acro with exhausting bite maxed is well more than enough to stop Rex in its tracks. The biggest thing for this matchup is to try and make them only bite your tail, as they have no bruiser, which if you do, and you really should to be honest, this will make this heavily in your favor even with being debuffed. If you have to face tank them while debuffed, which is fine, but not advised, try and keep in mind how much damage you are actually doing to them while debuffed to make sure the numbers add up, as Acro, while having a lot less health than Rex, can reduce your damage above 50% of 5 out of 3. Worst case scenario, don't be afraid to go into the water. You have a really big advantage in there over Acro. The Rex mirror matchup. The mirror matchup for Rex is downright really bad, as almost any size Rex, you can kill another Rex even with a pretty big size difference, but most of the time it does come down to size and talents, with bigger Rexes dogging on small Rexes a majority of the time, albeit winning barely by a hair. But if you are the same size, talents, and how fat you are is what it comes down to. On a bit of a side note, Rexes do tend to kill each other at the same time, even if there are HP differences due to how much damage Rex can output, so most Rexes will try and avoid fighting each other. Whoever can turn better or has more bruiser tends to win, if you're going tail to tail anyways, but damage and survival Rexes are no joke, as they might be able to tank an extra one or even two hits. All in all, never underestimate another Rex player, even if they are small. Also, avoid fighting in the water. You will cripple each other really bad and might die from drowning like I almost did in this video. The three aquatics. Moza and Krono, as long as you are not in super deep water, is not much of a problem. Rex can kill Moza if they get grabbed and don't let go, and Krono has to lunge to have any chance at winning, which requires time. Time in which you could be crossing, or getting to a better position. Elasmo is the only exception to this, as you will see in this video. Because of its funny neck, it almost looks like it's face tanking me. But in reality, it's just because I can't hit it. Try not to fight them in the water, especially on shore, and if they have exhausting bite, just don't try it. You won't win in the water, as Elasmo is the fastest thing in the ocean and everything, so don't do what I'm doing here. I was just really tired of them nipping at us, and I really wanted to get one, at least one kill. Your best bet is to wait till they get beached, as they are very slow, even with all the speed talents on land. But at the end of the day, Elasmo neck is a problem for everything at the moment, so don't feel too bad about this matchup. Velociraptor and Oryctodromius. You might be a little surprised I'm talking about these two, but funnily enough, Rex's hardest matchup, in my opinion, are these guys. Rex is terrible at turning and jumping, so even a Velo and Ori player that is not good can kill you if they are dedicated enough. Combine this with Veel being able to use Stamina Bite to keep Rex from running, and Ori having a form of CC that has no real counter to it, and you will quickly realize that on land, you are, as the pair of players like to call themselves, meals on wheels. Which is not actually true, they're just really bad at the game, but more on that in the para video. These two creatures also have what's called Sturdy, which allows them to survive a hit that would normally kill them, which I promise will infuriate you the first couple times this happens. In the water, you can largely avoid the problem of Velo and Ori, as they are pretty bad in the water and don't have nearly as much air to dive if you need to, though due to their very good jump, they can still traverse the top really well for some reason. Why this is a feature, you ask? Who knows? Because it only benefits one class of the roster. Another way you can protect yourself is by having smaller Rexes with you, as ironically, having a baby 0.6 dino is better than having another adult in the group versus these guys, as they can get under you to get them away without hitting you, or at least doing minimal damage, and hopefully proccing their sturdy. All in all, desync will be your best friend, and pray to the above gods that you will make it out of this alive. Just an end note to end on this section. I do want to say, in general, small creatures, including babies, are funnily enough really hard for Rex to kill with its bad turn and stamina, but babies are temporary and don't have sturdy, while Ori and Velo have an adult's worth of talents while remaining small. Now we're going to go into our next section for Rex builds. As always, these are always the builds I go, you don't have to go them. In my opinion, the best builds for Rex at the time of this video, in my opinion, is speed and combat, or combat and speed. This is massively due to the various talents that can help Rex traverse the area, and in very niche areas can clutch up in tight situations. For example, Aqua Rect, which is probably the most popular version of this build, and is simply the best land creature that can abuse this tree, does a significant amount of damage with out of element, and has a pretty decent swimsuit to boot. Not to mention, most of the aquatics can't really stand up to Rex in straight 1v1, so this build is fairly popular in the community. The other very popular version of this build is on the other side of the tree, and is very good at moving around hills, and with surefooted in play, allows you to catch some of the faster creatures in the game. This build also goes really good with Sneaky to optimize on Rex's Ambush Predator playstyle, which only recently really became a viable option with Titania, actually giving a lot of cover unlike the other maps. The second second most popular build is Combat Survival. Combat Survival pretty much allows you to do what Rex already does, but better. Rex is already fairly tanky compared to the rest of the roster, and maxing its damage while having extra HP, thick kite, strong bones, and healing makes this murder tank a huge wall to be down. This power comes at quite a huge price though, and your speed, stamina, and worst of all your turn is all pretty bad and can be exploited by the smaller creatures or creatures that use Nimble. I recommend this build when you have other Rexes with you or plan to stay in a tight space where you can't get ridden. The last build we're going to go over and I don't really recommend is Speed Survival. I'm really not sure why people go this build. I guess if you're trying to do hit and run tactics, this might work, but at the end of the day, Rex is just not an endurance hunter like Acro and really needs to burst down its prey. If you get caught by a Speed Combat Rex, you're more than likely dead as their damage is better than yours, and even with the extra HP that you have, you won't be able to kill them fast enough. Not to mention, they can just bite your tail for free damage. Now we're going to be going over the best talent section. Bruiser is by far Rex's best talent as it allows it to lock down targets and do good damage on tail hits, which it really needs for things like Megaraptor and Wevenator, which when paired with something like Stamina Bite makes it even better, with Stamina Bite giving you the edge that you would need if you didn't have Bruiser in the first place, but combined makes them both really strong. Auto of Element also makes Rex really strong because in storms you get the extra damage, and in the water or when you're grabbed by Moza, you can get a lot of damage off. Speed is good in any situation. Rex feels really slow without it, but it can also defend itself unlike some of the other creatures that I've gone over. And lastly, Strong Bones is really strong on Rex, mostly because of Cychania and Apato, but it's also good for Para as well. So if you can afford the points, definitely get Strong Bones. Life strategies and pros and cons. Playing solo as Rex is definitely much more viable than other creatures as it's a powerhouse to be contended with, no matter the size, but it's always good to have a buddy to back you up. I know it can be hard to find people to play carnivores with, as many people have predetermined groups they play with, or you may feel they're only joining you to spy on you, but there are so many people out there that want to grow the big carnivores that are in the same situation you are in, so try and make the first step to make a group. Who knows, maybe they'll be your friends for as long as you play this game, like how I met my friends. Definitely don't be afraid to live your life in the water, as most of the water boys other than Elasmo have a hard time with you if you are in a pond or at least close to shore. I would also stay away from hunting size and apatos in general if you want to get huge. Size aren't really worth fighting as they don't drop great gores efficiently wise to things like para, which is kind of strange as size is much harder to kill than para. And for apato, no matter how big you are, you will always have a high chance of death. I have seen 2.0 plus rexes in the old days die to 1.0 apatos, and it's just not worth dying to it if you're trying to get huge. And that concludes the video I have. Is there anything I missed? If I missed anything, feel free to leave a comment below for any future Rex mains.